this problem, we will combine two integration methods. The integral from 0 to pi over 9 of x times secant squared of 3x dx, we see as the product of the two functions. Identify each function using the limit. X as an algebraic, secant squared of 3x as a trig function. So u is x and the dv is secant squared 3x dx. From the bipartite technique, we use the formula u times v minus integral v du. U equals x gives us du is dx. For the dv, as secant squared 3x dx, we get v as the integral of the secant squared of 3x dx, which is the tangent of the 3x multiplied by 1/3 by using the u sub technique. Plug it in the formula. The u is the x. The v is 1 over 3 multiplied by the tangent of 3x minus the integral. The v, 1 over 3, the tangent of 3x. The du is the dx. Now we have 1 over 3 times x times the tangent of 3x minus 1 over 3, the integral, the tangent of 3x dx. To find the antiderivative of the tangent of 3x, we rewrite it as the sine of 3x over cosine of 3x, and then using the u sub technique. As u equals cosine of 3x, du is negative 3 sine of 3x dx by using the chain rule. Now we have 1/3 x multiplied by the tangent of 3x minus 1 over 3. The integral of the tangent 3x now becomes the integral of 1 over u multiplied by negative 1 over 3 du from here, which is negative 1 over 3 du equals sine of 3x dx. And that will give us 1 over 3x tangent 3x. Negative becomes positive 1 over 9 natural log of the absolute value of u, as u is cosine of 3x. And then evaluate from 0 to pi over 9. Use the common factor 1 over 3. Then we get x times the tangent 3x plus 1 over 3 natural log absolute value of cosine of 3x. From 0 to pi over 9. And next, we place the upper limit subtracted by the substitution using the lower limit. We get pi over 9. The tangent 3 times pi over 9 becomes pi over 3 plus 1 over 3 natural log absolute value of cosine pi over 3 minus 0 times tangent becomes 0 plus 1 over 3 natural log of the cosine at 0. The cosine at 0 is 1. Therefore, the natural log of 1 becomes 0. This term will be gone. The tangent of pi over 3, or the tangent of 60 degrees, is square root 3. And the cosine of pi over 3, which is the cosine of 60 degrees, is 1 over 2. Simplify the numbers to get 1 over 3. In the group, we have square root 3 times pi over 9 plus 1 over 3 times natural log of 1 half. And natural log of 1 half is the same as negative natural log 2. Then we can rewrite the answer as square root 3 over 27 pi minus 1 over 9 times natural log 2. Another problem of combining two integration methods. Integral from 0 to pi over 2. Nah. This problem, we use two. In this problem, we use two integration techniques. Let's look at another example using more than one integration technique. Definite integral from 0 to pi squared over 4 of psi of square root x dx. We see as one function psi of square root x, but it has the composite form. Therefore, we're going to start with the u sub technique by letting u be square root x. Du is the differential of square root x, which is 1 over 2 square root x dx. Or 2 square root x times du equals dx. Since the square root x is the u, that means we have 2 times u du as dx. Now we replace into the integral. So the integral, the psi of u multiplied by the dx, which is 2u du. And the lower limit, upper limit, as x equals 0, u is square root 0 or 0. X equals pi squared over 4. The u, which is the square root of pi squared over 4. Gives us pi over 2, lower limit 0, upper limit pi over 2 for the variable u. And then the problem becomes the by parts integral of the u times psi u du. Identify the two functions using Liet. The u as the algebraic. The psi u is a trig function. And this time, the u is a polynomial function. We're going to start the tabular method or use the tabular method to find the integration for the rest of the problem. The left column, find the derivative. The right column, find the antiderivative. Start with the u. And the right column is the psi u. The derivative of the u is 1, and then another derivative, we get 0. The right column, the psi u, the antiderivative would be cosine u with a negative sign. And then another antiderivative of negative cosine u is negative psi u. That gives us two products. The first product is the product of the u and negative cosine u with the plus sign for this product and the minus for the next product, which is the product of the 1 and the negative psi u. evaluate from 0 to pi over 2. Clean up the expression a little bit to be 2 times negative u cosine u plus psi u from 0 to pi over 2. Replace the upper limit to get negative pi over 2 cosine of pi over 2 plus psi of pi over 2 subtracted by negative 0 times cosine at 0 plus psi at 0. So the second group here becomes 0. The psi at pi over 2 equals 1, cosine at pi over 2 equals 0. That gives us the answer 2 times 1 or just 2.